friends. Welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new here. My name is Jen. I'm a certified weight loss and nutrition coach and I'm on the WW or the Weight Watchers Blue Plan. It's Wednesday, so it's another what I eat in a day. I'm going to take you guys along with me today. You're going to see everything that I'm eating. I have a really good easy. And when I say easy, I mean 30-minute dinner recipe to share with you guys and just some fun along the way today. So if you're excited, give this video a big, huge thumbs up. And also, if you're not yet subscribed to my channel, I'd love to have you join this community. All you have to do is hit the little subscribe button and of course the bell next to it so you're notified whenever new videos are uploaded. That way you're not missing a single video. Check out the description box down below where you'll find the first product of my new small business, my 2021 custom calendar. Customize it to you to track your food, your activity, your water, self-care, and a little bit of day-to-day activity as well. It is the perfect calendar to help you reach your goals in 2021. And it's still early in the year. I'm shipping the same day. So while they're still available, get your hands on the 2021 calendar. Don't forget to check out the description box as well for my nutrition coaching, where I offer personalized to you macros and calorie calculation essential for the new year. How do you lose weight if you don't know exactly how much you should be eating? So definitely take advantage of that. You'll also find 30 and 60 minute one-on-one coaching sessions for a little bit of individualized support. So check out my website down below. Links, discount codes to all of my favorite things are also in that description box, as well as my Facebook group, another community that would absolutely love to have you be part of it. So without further ado, we have a super fun day today. Lots of good food and a fantastic dinner recipe. So let's get started. I could fly through the wind. It's 7:04 a.m. and I just filled up my first cup of water for the day. You can see that I have a new gallon water bottle. So my blue bottle cracked. I think it was my fault. When I put the lid on, I think I pushed too hard. So it had a big crack right here. Whenever I would fill up my smaller cup, it would just leak everywhere. So I ordered this one off of Amazon. It does have all the fun. Hydrate yourself, don't give up. It's a really pretty kind of tie-dye pattern. I'll link it down below for you guys. It comes in a ton of colors. It's less than $20 and it's a different type of plastic. It's more of like a soft plastic, so I don't anticipate that it will crack as easily. But you can see I'm at the 7 a.m. mark and I just filled up my first cup. So today's goal is to drink this entire gallon of water, as always. So here is my breakfast. I'm super excited. It looks so delicious. So I decided to go ahead and make myself some avocado toast. So I just used this buttermilk bread. One slice of this is 3 smart points. I cooked up one full egg and one egg white here in this little microwave egg cooker. This thing is a game changer, you guys. I bought it off of Amazon. I'll link it down below for you guys. You literally throw your egg in there in the microwave for 1 minute and you have a perfectly cooked shaped egg for toast or English muffins. So I went ahead and cooked my egg in there with just a little bit of the Trader Joe's onion salt. These are the eggs that I absolutely love. You can find these at Walmart. Really the best price for these is at Walmart. And then I fried up in a pan just 3 slices of this Jones Canadian bacon. It's only 1 point for 3 slices, 60 calories, but 10 grams of protein. So I like to add it to breakfast for a real big punch of protein. I weighed out 50 grams of avocado here on my food scale. Again, I'll link this down below for you guys as well. If you haven't seen my 20 must-haves for weight loss, check out that video. I go over all of my must-haves moving into 2021 for weight loss, and my food scale is one of those. I'll make sure that video is linked as well for you guys. And then I just have a little bowl here mixed of blackberries and blueberries. So my lunch is 1 point for the Canadian bacon, 3 for the toast, 3 for the avocado, 7 smart points, and it's packed with healthy fats, protein, and I'm getting in some fruit. I am meal prepping. As you can see here, we've got the whole setup going on, but I'm not hungry for a snack this morning. It's already 10 o'clock, so I don't really think I need a snack, but I am going to drink this Better Booch kombucha. I count this as one smart point. This is the Morning Glory, which is basically peach and black tea. It is delicious. It's 30 calories for half of the can, so it's 60 calories total. I think it ends up being 2 or 3 points, but I just count it as 1 point. So this, I guess, is my morning snack. Are you in the kitchen with me today, babe? Say, we're prepping our meals for the week, and I am scavengering and vacuuming up anything that falls, right? Yeah, you sure are, princess. And you've been in and out between outside in the snow, yeah, and in bed. You sure have. Do you guys see this? That's Lola's little burrow she's dug out on my side of the bed so that she can lay in there. You too. Not spoiled or anything. Nope, not spoiled at all. Are you ready for the finished bathroom 2 months later? And I say finished, but it's not finished. We're still waiting on the blind that our contractor measured wrong, so we had to order a new one, and the corner shelves that are going in our shower. But the bathroom is incredible. I did post some pictures on my personal Facebook page, but I wanted to show you guys. So are you ready for the big reveal? We're obsessed. We are so obsessed with our bathroom. It's everything that we wanted. We literally could not have asked for more when it came to what we were after. So when you first walk in, you see the double sink vanity here. What I love about the new vanity is the cabinets. They are soft close, so no more slamming cabinets in the middle of the night. The countertops, even though they had to be redone, turned out absolutely gorgeous. We have nice bronze. These are the spigot type of faucets, which we love. I ended up going to Target and finding these brushed bronze tissue paper holder and a couple of soap dispensers for us. And then the mirrors with the matching light fixtures. These were purchased off of Etsy. They're super cute. The lights, I don't know if you can see, but they're mason jars, and it just brings that whole like rustic vibe that we were after here in our bathroom. The mirrors I love too, because they have these nice metal brackets on there that are bronze, oil rubbed bronze, so it all kind of ties together. So here is another look at the vanity. Oh, one more thing I want to show you guys is, it may not translate on camera, but I don't know if you can see that this is a rough edge. So it's kind of a jagged edge. It's called polished chisel. We had that done on all of the exposed edges because, again, rustic. It gives it that really rustic vibe. We ended up putting our hamper here, just like in our old bathroom. And then this is the window in the bathroom that doesn't have a blind because it was measured incorrectly. The light fixture is this rusted metal light fixture from Etsy. It's just really cool. It looks fantastic in here. We popped in an Edison bulb. And then this is the star of the show, in my opinion, and that is my makeup vanity. So if you remember, there was a garden tub in this corner. I'll pop a picture in right here for you. I'll kind of throw some before and afters in as we go through the tour. But there was a garden tub here that we never used that just collected dust. And I am really in need of a makeup vanity because I love to do my makeup and my hair, and it's just convenient to have my own space for that. So we actually had this custom made with 7 drawers. We did not put hardware here on the middle drawer just because I didn't want to have to lean onto the middle drawer and have that hardware kind of gouge into me as I was getting ready. But you guys, it turned out so nice. It's everything that I need with soft close drawers. I've got it laid out where, like, this is the makeup I use every day, and I just have it laid out so perfect for me. And we decided not to put a big mirror on this wall because we couldn't find one that we liked that went with the rustic aesthetic. And actually, I'm really glad that we didn't, because I've just been using this LED mirror here. It just turns on and you have nice light so that you can put your makeup on. And the other thing about having it up here on the wall is that the mirror itself would be really far away as I was getting ready. And this I can bring right up to my face, see my makeup. I can even do my hair in this mirror. I'll link this down below for you guys. I got this on Amazon. And then I put a couple of cute holders here for my cotton balls and cotton pads and cotton swabs. And then of course my brushes. And then we decided instead of the mirror to do just kind of a couple of floating shelves with some rustic decor. So these shelves are adorable. They're from Hobby Lobby. I found this cute candle at TJ Maxx. This plant is also from Hobby Lobby, as well as this one up here. And then these trees were in Hobby Lobby's Christmas section. So they were super, super affordable and they just go really well in here. So this kind of brings in that entire rustic vibe above my vanity. And I think it looks much better than if we would have popped in a mirror. Hello again. She's laying on our new rug. This is our new flooring that we picked for our bathroom. We will be carrying this flooring throughout our entire house. And then our shower. So I'm gonna pop in a picture here of what the shower was before. So we decided to go with a floor-to-ceiling walk-in shower so that we had a huge, glorious shower. And it came out better than I could have ever even asked for. So we're waiting for little corner shelves to go right here in the corner. But I'll take you guys into the shower. So this is the only step up. You literally have to just step up this one little area. So we went with that rock floor that carried through to the bench. We had him put in two small niches, one for Troy and then a larger niche for me over here, which makes it really nice and convenient. We picked a tile that resembles wood, so again, for that rustic feel. And then over here, we decided to go with two shower heads and the removable wand. I definitely wanted a wand to like spray off the walls and things. We went with an 8-inch kind of rain shower head here and this big 12-inch shower head here. So when you're in here, it is literally glorious with the two shower heads. And then again, we have the wand as an option if we want to spray down ourselves or the walls. And the dials allow you to turn on each of the shower heads and the wand individually, which is also really, really nice. And then as you walk out of the shower, we have a linen cabinet, which we had one of these before, and it's a huge game changer. When we had the double sink vanity and my makeup vanity made, we had a linen cabinet made that was the same dimensions as our old one because we just loved it so much. I mean, storage wise, it's amazing. I mean, it really makes a big difference on bathroom storage. And then this one, this linen cabinet, we had extra shelves put in so that we could even have more storage instead of being limited. Our other linen cabinet only had two shelves, so we had this one made with four. We used the same hardware and the soft close. Above our toilet, we picked up this cute mousse from Hobby Lobby. And then, of course, our same toilet that we had before. Troy went ahead and replaced the grate with one that matches a little bit better. And then we bought new toilet paper holders that are black. Nice heavy duty metal toilet paper and towel bar holder that hold our towels. And then we ended up going with a solid wood door, which we're so incredibly happy that we did. We just stained it a very neutral stain so you could see all of the knots in it. And then we had the molding stained a little bit darker so that it matches the flooring and the cabinetry. This cute mousse head we used to put our towel on, and this is from Hobby Lobby. And then we searched high and low for a rustic large enough clock above our door to see from the shower, and this was at Lowe's for about $40, so we picked that up. So that's kind of what you see as you walk out of the bathroom, but we're really happy. I mean, it truly turned out better than we could have expected. It's everything that that we wanted and more. It cost almost double what we initially anticipated, but we truly are so happy, and this is the house we are going to live in forever, so it was worth the investment for us. Oh, one last thing. We replaced the crummy fan with this one that actually has a fan, a light, and heat. So that's really nice for these cold winter nights. So that's our bathroom. Let me know down in the comments what you guys think. If you like it, if you see anything that you would change, let me know down in the comments. But yeah, we are pretty darn happy with how everything turned out. We couldn't seriously be any happier. So this is my lunch for today. If you didn't know, our oven broke about a week ago, so we don't have any access to the oven portion, just the stovetop. So we've been making some modifications, as you saw in meal prep on Monday, to make dinners without having an oven. So I utilize my Instant Pot for this. This is sausage and rice. I added a ton of vegetables, zucchini, carrots, onions. I used white rice and wild rice to give it a little bit of heartiness. And it's really, really delicious. It definitely has that Creole or Cajun vibe, which I really, really liked. My husband cared for it a little less than I did, so I don't know that he'll eat the leftovers. So I thought that I would do that and use it up instead of throwing it away and have it for lunch today. So this is 7 points. There's some chicken sausage in there, the rice, the veggies. And then I am on my water number 3 or 4 for the day. I'll definitely get the gallon done. I don't know if I'll have a dessert after lunch, but if I do, I'll be back to show you. Dessert are these trolley sour gummy minis. These are super good. In the Valentine section, I showed these in my grocery haul. This little package is 45 calories and 2 points, and there's quite a few in here. So it's a nice little sweet treat after a meal. So that's going to finish up my lunch. And I didn't mention, but I did put it on the screen that my lunch was 7 points, and this is 2 points. It's almost 3 o'clock. I'm going to have a snack. I'm swamped today, so my snack is quick and simple. I still have the Alani Nu Munchies bars from that video I did months and months ago, testing these out. They do hurt my stomach. I can only have them very, very far and few between. I think I have 2 or 3 left, so I'm actually going to have one. It's been a long time. They taste good. They do not have the best ingredients, and the mannitol in them just kills my stomach, especially if I have them back-to-back days, but it's been a long time. And again, I need something quick and easy, so I'm gonna have one of those. And then one of the Ora Bora waters and Cactus Rose. These came from Thrive Market. You guys, these waters are the best. I ordered $50 worth of these sparkling waters because they were on sale. Perfection when it comes to ingredients. Definitely check out Thrive. They're having a huge promo right now where you get 25% off of your first order and a free gift when you join. They have 1 month and year-long memberships. Love Thrive. I just put out a video on Sunday of a Thrive haul for 2021, so I'll link that video down below for you. The water is 0 points and the Alani Nu bar is 5, so this is my 5 smart point snack. For tonight's dinner, we're making 30-minute Mongolian beef. I'm always here for a recipe that's 30 minutes, so I'm really excited for this. Some Chinese fake out vibe. So let me show you what's in dinner. First, you'll need some oil. This is the Chosen Foods avocado oil. Cornstarch. We are going to put our Mongolian beef over some rice. So I'm using this organic white rice, minced garlic, fresh ginger or ground ginger, whatever you have on hand, a brown sugar alternative. I'm using Lakanto. Again, don't forget about it being linked down below for 15% off for you. Soy sauce, salt, and then you need some steak or some beef. So I'm actually using this beef from my butcher box. So this is the grass-fed beef tri-tip steak, and this is a little over 1 pound. I am going to cut off any fat, so I figured it at about 1 pound for the calories of meat. This is from my butcher box. Again, butcher box is linked down below for you guys with $30 off your first box. Highly recommend. The meat is out of this world. And then you'll need some green onions. So let's get started. First thing I'm going to do is slice up the steak into thin slices. And then we only want the green portion of the green onion, so I'm going to slice all of those off as well. My steak is all cut up. So into a Ziploc bag, I put 1/3 cup of cornstarch. I'm going to add the meat to the bag and shake it up. So I added 1 tablespoon of oil and the steak covered in cornstarch to my pan. over medium high. We're going to let this cook until it's crispy. And then in another pan here, I started 2 cups of water. I'm going to cook 1 cup of uncooked rice. And that's going to be what we're going to pair with the Mongolian beef. The rice is coming right along and the beef is done. So we're going to remove the beef, add it to a plate here with a little bit of salt and pop in the garlic. I added in a big scoop of minced garlic. I'm going to let it just start to cook a little bit until it's fragrant. I added in 1/3 cup of soy sauce, 1/3 cup of the brown sugar, and about 1/3 cup of water. And then we're going to stir this and let it come to a boil. Once it comes to a boil, add in your ginger and reintroduce your steak to the mix. We're going to let this cook just for a few minutes until it has a chance to meld all the flavors. As the beef simmers, it's going to thicken up from the cornstarch that we added in the beginning. Once it's nice and thick, we're going to add in the cut up green onions. Stir those in, let those soften just a couple minutes, and it's ready to go. And the rice is also ready to go. So I'll plate this up, be back to share points and calories. So here is my dinner. So the Mongolian beef makes 6 servings. It is 4 smart points per serving on all the plans just for the beef mixture, which this is quite a bit of beef and sauce. And then I have 3 points worth of rice as well. So my dinner is going to be 7 smart points. It is 154 calories just for the beef mixture. My gallon of water is done for the day. I'm gonna refill it up for tomorrow. For dessert tonight, I'm having Smart Sweets. So I have all the different flavors. These are the peach rings. I love these. This is probably number 2 on my list of favorites. And then these are the gummy worms that they released around Halloween. These are okay. And then the sweet fish are also really good. These are similar to Swedish fish. And then the licorice or the twist they released not too long ago either. They're okay. I would pair them kind of along with the gummy worms. And then I also have the watermelon ones, which are my very favorite. That's actually what I'm gonna have tonight. Those are the sour melon bites. This whole bag, and there is a ton in here, is only 3 smart points, 100 calories. I love Smart Sweets. I love candy. So this is a great dupe for me for only 3 points. And there is a ton in this bag. So this is going to be tonight's dessert. Look at all of them. I mean, there's just a ton in this bag. Can't beat it for 3 points. I also have Smart Sweets linked down below with 10% off. They do offer free shipping as well. So definitely check them out and use the code in the description box for 10% off.
Much for coming along with me on another What I Eat in a Day on WW. I hope you enjoyed today's video seeing our completed bathroom remodel. It was 2 months in the making and we are so relieved and in love with how it turned out. So definitely down in the comments, let me know what you guys think. I'd love to hear your feedback. Also make sure you're checking out the description box for that 2021 calendar. Don't miss out, get your hands on one. It's a game changer for the new year. Also my nutrition coaching, my Facebook group, and links and discount codes to everything that I shared in today's video and my favorite things down below for you guys. If you enjoyed today's What I Eat in a Day, please give it a big thumbs up. It really means a lot to me and definitely, definitely helps out my channel. And if you're new or not yet subscribed, go ahead and hit that little subscribe button and the bell next to it so you're notified when I upload. I do a What I Eat in a Day every Wednesday, so you don't wanna miss out. Thank you guys again so much for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye.